Hi, I'm Jason Morrell, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to get from here to here. Let me break this down for you. The blue text uses standard multi-level numbering, legal style. That means 1, 1.1, 1.1.1, and 1.1.1.1. Underneath each of the four main headings, there are some subheadings just labelled A and B and C and so on, and they're indented to be in line with the main heading above them. So how do I do this? Let's find out. Now don't forget, if you find this video useful, you'll find some downloadable resources, including this very template, in the description below. Check that out after this video. Let's maximize this main screen here. And let's start by selecting all the text, going to the multi-level number icon, and choosing Define New Multi-Level List. Now first up, we're going to define the standard numbering for the first four levels from scratch. Doesn't take very long. So first of all, on level one, we're going to clear this enter formatting for number and just choose a simple 1, 2, 3 style numbering followed by a dot. For level two, we're going to wipe that clean as well. Now level two is dependent on level one to get its main number followed by a dot followed by the number for this level, which again is 1, 2, 3. Third level, same again, let's clear that box out. This is dependent on levels 1 and 2, starting with level 1, followed by a dot, then level 2, followed by another dot, followed by the number style for this level, which again is 1, 2, 3. Level 4, again, let's wipe this clean, and start by saying level 1, followed by a dot, level 2, followed by a dot, level 3, followed by a dot, and then the number style for this level, which is 1, 2, 3. So that's building up the legal style numbering from scratch for the first four levels. Now very quickly, I'm also going to set the indentation and positioning for each of these four levels and link them to an appropriate style. I'm just going to use the standard heading 1 through to heading 4 for these four levels. So first up, level 1, I'm going to align the number at 0 centimeters, that's the left margin, and indent it by 1 centimeter. For level 2, I'm going to indent it at 1 centimeter for the number and 2 centimeters for the text that follows the number. On level 3, I'm going to indent it at 2 centimeters, but indent the text at 3.5 centimeters. That gives it a bit of space for the 3-digit number to expand. And then level 4, I'm going to go 3.5 centimeters as my starting point for the number and go to 5 centimeters for the text that follows the number. So that's all that bit done. Then let's go back to level 1 again. Let's link this to heading 1. Level 2, link that to heading 2. Level 3, link that to heading 3. And level 4, link that to heading 4. So that's the first four levels done. Now in between each of the levels, there are the ABC single letter numbering sequence. And we're going to make use of another 4 of these available 9 numbering levels. We're going to use 5 through to 8. Now you may be asking, why do we need to create 4 levels for the ABC numbering? It should be like one level that can be used anywhere under any of the headings. Now the problem with that approach is that if you're under heading 1, you want ABC, but if you're under heading 2, you also want that to be ABC, but reset for every heading 2. If you create it as one single style, the numbering is going to be continuous, and the only thing that resets it is the very top level. So we've got to create a ABC style sub-level for each of these four main headings. And that's why we're going to be using 5 through to 8 here. So let's start at level 5. And again, wipe this out. And we're just going to use a ABC lowercase numbering system, followed by a bracket or a dot or whatever is your preference. And repeat this for each of the levels going through to level 8. So again, wipe out what's there. Choose a lowercase ABC, followed by a bracket. Then level 7, again, wipe out what's there. That's a lowercase ABC, followed by a bracket. And then level 8, same thing. Wipe out what's there if you need to, and lowercase ABC, followed by a bracket. Now you might be thinking as well, why don't I just use what's there? Well, you can't rely that what's there is accurate. It's going to be working properly by the time you get to it. So whenever I create a brand new numbering system, I always wipe out what's there, build it up from scratch so I know that what I'm working with is my work. I'm not relying on what anybody else has done before me. It's a good approach. You might want to take note of that. So again, I'm going to set the indentation and positioning and link each of these levels to a style. So let's start at number 5. We're going to align this at 1 centimeter, and the text that follows it, 2 centimeters, is fine. For level 6, we're going to align that at 2 centimeters, and the text that follows it at 3 centimeters. For level 7, we're going to align this at 3.5 centimeters, and the following text is going to be 4.5 centimeters. And for the last one, we're going to align this at 5 centimeters, and the text that follows at 6 centimeters. So by aligning it to these measurements, each subheading ABC is going to be in line with the heading text for the appropriate level above it. Then we attach each one to an appropriate style. So level 5, we're going to link to heading 5. Level 6, we're going to link to heading 6. Level 7, to heading 7. And level 8, to heading 8. And at this point, it's always worth checking the preview to make sure that the heading numbers you've selected are correct. It's very easy to make a mistake and choose the wrong one here. Now, if we go back to level 2, we can see that every level 2 heading restarts after level 1. And if we went to level 3, every level 3 heading restarts after level 2. So in the same way, we're going to take each of our ABC sublists and restart it at the appropriate point. So level 5 is the subheading for heading 1. So we're going to change this to level 1 for level 5. For level 6, this needs to restart for every heading 2 or level 2. For level 7, which is the ABC for the third level heading, we restart after level 3. And on level 8, we restart after level 4. At this point, let's click OK and let's take a look. Okay, so looking at what we have here, I noticed straight away there's a glitch, a bit of a mistake, a bug in Microsoft Word. Who would have thought? Now, this happens fairly frequently. We've just been through the process of setting up the multi-level numbering and attaching each level of numbering to a style. But if we look at the style gallery and preview each of these levels, you can see that the numbering is not appearing here. And even just by hovering over heading 1, for example, we can see that that's not adding heading 1 that we want to see. And if we went to level 2, you wouldn't be seeing the 1.1 and then the text that follows. What we need to do is to go back to the multi-level numbering icon, choose Define New Multi-Level List. Now, looking in the preview here, you can see it's still got all the numbering system we set up. But looking on the right-hand side, it's lost the link to the style. Now, I don't know why it does this. It seems to happen intermittently for no good reason, but it happens fairly frequently as well. So it's good to recognize it, and it's good to see it in this video. So it's not your fault, basically. It's Word's fault. So we're going to go through again for levels 1 through to 8 and just relink the styles. So level 1 links to heading 1. Level 2 to heading 2. Level 3 to heading 3. Level 4 to heading 4. Level 5 to heading 5. Level 6 to heading 6. Level 7 to heading 7. And level 8 to heading 8. Now, fingers crossed, this time when we click OK, that's good news. In the style gallery at the top, we can now see the numbers are appearing before each of the heading styles. So that means everything currently is on heading 1. So if we select the two heading 5s here, yes, we can go to the style gallery at the top, and by clicking the More button, we can then find heading 5. But if you've got a lot of this stuff to do, it's actually worth clicking the little launcher here to display the styles pane, and then all of your headings are listed towards the top generally. So here we're going to choose heading 5. There's our AB. Now it's gone to uppercase, and that's probably because of the styling, which we'll address in just a moment. So heading 2, we're going to apply heading 2 there. Heading 6, a couple of those. Heading 6. Heading 3. A couple of heading 7s. Heading 4. couple of heading 8s. Okay, so you can see the major headings, heading 1, heading 2, heading 3, heading 4. They've got the cascading numbering. And again, this is something that often happens, especially if you've got stuff going on in between the main headings that are also styled. All we've got to do here to rectify the 1.2 is to double click it so you can see the 1.2 highlighted, right click and restart at 1. Once it's been reset, it won't stuff up again. Same thing down here. So it's meant to start at 1. So we select it, right click, restart at 1. And this last one here, right click again and restart at 1. So now all that's left to do is to adjust the styling for each of the headings. Now my preference is to take heading 1, which is like your major heading, your big headings, and just make that into a nice big font. Let's say a 20, 22, 24, something of that sort of size. And then from there, each subsequent sub-level, you can reduce by a couple of points in font size. Starting with heading 1, let's right click here and modify. Let's make this a size 22, let's say. Blue's fine. Maybe make it bold as well, just to stand out. Click OK. For heading 2, we're going to right click and modify. For this, I'm going to choose 2 points down, which is a size 20. The blue is fine. And you can either bold it as well or not. And click OK. And then for heading 3, I'm going to make that a size 16. Sorry, an 18. And the rest is fine. And for heading 4, a size 16. So these are all headings, don't forget. So it's good to have them a little bit larger. Now, as for the subheadings in between, for the stuff underneath heading 1 and heading 2, they are capitalized. And the second one's actually italicized as well. And also under heading 4, they're italicized. We've got a few things to fix here. Let's start with heading 5. We're going to right click here and modify. We're going to first of all go to the format and then font and just turn off the all caps. And the rest should be fine on that one. That's good. And then we go to heading 6, so right click and modify. We need to turn off the italic and also go to format and then font and again turn off the all caps. So that's that one done. The stuff under heading 3, which is the heading 7s, we're going to right click on heading 7 and choose modify. And we don't need the bold there, and that's probably the only thing that needs changing. And the last one there is bolded and italicized. So that's heading 8. So right click here and modify. And then we're going to turn off the bold and the italic and click OK. Now in the previous example, we also just added different colors for the subheadings. All of that stuff is controlled by the styles like you've just seen. So you can really tailor that to your needs. So there we go. It's a bit of a process, but in these sorts of situations, you just need to work out what you need, get your head down and just go through the process. There will be some bugs that come up as you just saw there. There's no real way to avoid those or know when they're going to come up. But once you've been doing this long enough, you'll recognize what they are and what you've got to do to fix them. It's just part of the game, unfortunately. We've covered quite a bit there, and I'm hoping that you've taken some value from this video. If that's the case, if this has helped you, if this has given you some ideas, if it's helped you debug some problems that you've been having, please share that in the comments below. I love reading the comments. I respond to everyone as well, and I appreciate everybody that takes the time to write a comment. Again, thanks for watching through to the end. Really appreciate you. I'll see you again in the next video. See you guys.